Ayan, meron tayong last speaker for today. Ayan, guys. So, last July 17, we started this Aneno webinar series where we talk about COVID-19 and we busted some myths and misconceptions. We also learned how to adopt the new normal, especially here in our city, Zamboanga. Ayan, yesterday we discussed naman about mental health awareness and we learned how to thrive while surviving. Today we will be talking about the screen between us, drawing closer while apart. I would like to introduce to you our final speaker. He graduated Bachelor of Secondary Education as cum laude in Western Mindanao State University. He is a former editor-in-chief of the Guru publication of Western Mindanao State University College of Education. He is a licensed professional teacher and eligible for civil service by virtue of Presidential Decree Number 907. He is also he also hosted for regional, national, and international events and conferences. He is a resource speaker, an instructor, coach, debater, and moderator, and he is currently an English department chairperson of Ateneo de Zamboanga University Senior High School Department. Let us all welcome and give a warm round of applause to Mr. Ramses Andaya. Ayan.
Hi, good afternoon. But you can hear me. I'm sorry, you can hear me. Okay lang, you can. Okay, very good. Sige. So, allow me to share my screen. Disabled. So, sa host natin pa. Okay. Mag-share ako ng screen, please. Pabigyan ako ng access to the screen sharing. There. Okay. So, okay. Sige, nakikita niyo ba yung screen ko? Okay, okay yung screen? Okay, very good. Sige. So, good afternoon. So, we're going to talk about session 3 this afternoon. It's going to be the screen between us, strengthening relationship amidst the global pandemic. So, this will not take really too long. This, let's try our best to make this very, very interactive. So kung may mga tanong tayo, you can start keying it in, okay lang. Start keying in your answer, yung questions rather, para mamaya masagot natin. Pero makakaroon muna tayo ng activity ha. So the activity is called an SBD. I want everybody to participate sa SBD. Ano ba yung SBD? S stands for sana. Okay? B for baka and D for dapat. So what are we supposed to do? For sana, gusto kong i-key in nyo lang sa chat box kung ano yung mga hopes, desires and inspirations nyo. Siguro at this time of pandemic, ano ba yung mga, saan ba tayo positibo? Ano pa ba yung mga gusto nating ma-achieve? Sa baka naman, we have to write down ano yung mga apprehensions natin, fears or doubts. I know most of us, no, ang ating apprehensions talaga is paano ba magsa-start ang school year? If this is the kind of setup we have for learning, paano kaya ma-maximize ba yung learning? I think some of you are questioning already kung bakit ganito kataas yung tuition fee, pero ganito naman yung way of learning. I know things like that. So, you can key it in. I know everybody naman, no, for everyone who's here, this is going to really be for us lang naman din. So, yung dapat, no, you can just write the resolutions. Kung, kumbaga parang at the end of it, ano ba yung mga actions or commitments na gagawin ninyo? So, I will only be giving you perhaps 2 to 3 minutes. Mag-isip. Lagyan lang ng S. Okay? Kung ano yung mga sana mo. Tapos, or we can start with sana. Sige, I'll give you a minute or two. Think of your sana. Ano yung mga sana natin? Pwedeng sana sa webinar. Pwedeng sana sa schooling. Pwedeng sana sa city. Pwedeng sana sa Philippines. Pwedeng sana sa buong mundo. Okay, I'll give you a minute or two to key in your sana. Sa chat box lang natin. We'll start with sana. Sige, let's see. Tingnan natin kung ano yun yung mga sana natin. Oh yes, so we have from Sarah, sana matapos na yung pandemic. From Jaja, I was the, you know who. And then we have Danielle. As for Von, sa makapagsanggip na. Actually, opo, promise din ata ni Von sa akin yan kung matatandaan ko. Parang Von promised me for a sanggip. Okay, sana there would be an academic freeze. I know, yeah, kailan, no? I think a lot of students are really clamoring for academic freeze. But I think one of the low points of academic freeze is that everybody kasi will be affected. Eh. Most importantly, by the way, the private sector. The public sector, the academic freeze will not really be a big problem because they're supported by the government. But for private sectors like our institution, mahirap yung academic freeze kasi wala tayong ibang source of funding kung hindi what's inside us. But I really understand the point. Sige. For Daniel, sana matapos yung pandemic. For Robert, sana maging competent ang government. Mm-hmm. For Wina, sana okay na lahat. I also hope for that. For Jamie, sana wala nang mahirap. I also think of the same. For Allen, sana maging okay ng situation ngayon. For, I know, Dane, sana may grades na sa portal. Yes, para mabawasan na no yung ano natin, yung fear, yung anxiety. Sana okay na lahat ako into Jersey. Kay Rana, sana makatrabaho na ako para maka-endol na ako. Yeah, that's good, no? I like it, Rana, no? Kasi you're trying your best to look for a job, which later on we're going to talk about. Hopefully, masagot yan ng session ko ngayon, Rana. And then for Justin, everything will go back to normal. As what I always hear them, Justin, no? There's no going back to normal na daw. I mean, the new normal is the new normal. So parabang there might be changes on how things are going to be, but we just hope for the best na lang siguro, no? For Armaline, sana I would be able to make my parents proud. That's always our ultimate goal. Ako nga, even if I finish studies already, yun pa rin yung goal ko eh. To make my parents proud. To make them, you know, to make them somehow feel na what I'm doing is for them. Sometimes kasi our parents are not aware, no, that what we've been doing are for them. Sige lang, when you finish studies, let them go to Hajj. You know, that's always the ultimate goal of a Muslim son or daughter to make your parents go to Hajj, for example, also give them a house or so on and so forth. Sana makalaag na, I feel you, LB, so much. So sana makalaag na, sana matapos ng pandemic, maging okay yung lahat, maka-enroll, sana may vaccine. But I know, Shifano, they're working on that. Russia, I think, tapos na ata for UK, they're on their last phase of trial. Sana matapos na din ang lahat. According to Alhisha, sana may zero case na ang buong mundo. Same, sana maging okay ng lahat. Maging RN tayo. Yes, Penny. Oh, hopefully, lahat kayo maging registered nurse. Honestly, no, more than ever, this is the time we needed people like you. This is the time we needed nurses. This is the time we needed medical practitioners. This is the time we needed medical technologies. The time we needed pharmacies. You see, this is how crucial your roles are in the healthcare system of the country. When the healthcare system of the country dies, everything else will follow. Kaya importante yung role ninyo as nurses and other medical practitioners. Sana safe ng lahat. Yeah, sana may face-to-face review na. That's also my problem because I'm reviewing, no? So for mga licensure exams and giving reviews, nahihirapan kami sa ganito. Sana walang miscellaneous fee. Yeah, I'm trying my best to internalize on that, but you see, there are a lot of things kasi we are looking for eh. Kaya nahihirapan tayo sa miscellaneous, kailangan talagang idagdag. Sana may clearance na, sana may patutunguhan tong webinar na to. Yeah, we will try our best, Ryan, ang bawat pagsugpo ng pandemya, we will. Okay, sana gumaling na lahat ng may sakit, sana di na mag-crash ang portal. I think, Ryman, no, pagsabay-sabay kasi nagka-crash ang portal. Sana walang bad news, gumising ang ibang participants. Thank you, Josh, sa pag-remind sa kanila. Sana ma-flatten ang curve and so on and so forth. Hindi na lumala. Sana wala ng power interruption. That's the reason why we're having a Monday session. Sige, sana wala ng blackout. So those are our sana. No? If you notice, most of our sana are no longer about us, but about other people. And that means we are maturing. That means we are becoming people with wisdom. Kasi when you start thinking of other people, that's when you realize that the life we have now is not just for you, but for other people. I like your point there, no? Parang nare-realize mo ngayon na, ay, oo, no, hindi na lang pala kasi buhay ko ang iniingatan ko, even other people. And that's a very good point. I like that. So now, I wanted to start keying in ano yung mga baka natin, ano yung mga apprehensions, ano yung mga takot at saka yung doubts ninyo. So you start keying it in, So, ano yung mga baka natin sa buhay? Ano yung mga feeling mo hanggang ngayon takot na takot ka? Perhaps natatakot kang mag-break kayo within the pandemic kasi alam mo communication may be, you know, life may be too idle but communication isn't that good. Parang ganun. So you can start keying it in. So ano yung mga baka natin? I'm giving a minute or two to key it in sa ating chat box. Baka di na safe ang PH dahil sa warrantless arrest. Yeah, I understand, no, the anti-terrorism law. So I think I don't know kung I haven't really read the entire law. Siguro naman may mga parts doon na may mga amendments na ginawa. Hopefully, ako lang naman at the end of the day, if the government thinks of a law, it has to be for the people, not just for the government. If they're thinking of a law that's for the people, then therefore, that's going to be a good law. Sana mas lalong lumala ang pag... Baka mas lalong lumala ang pandemic, wag naman sana. I heard, Shelo, no, that meron na namang lumalabas na bagong strand ng pandemic, parang it rooted on the coronavirus 19, and then may mutation na nangyayari. I hope it wouldn't really get worse. Baka matagalan ng vaccine production. I get, you know, with that. Kasi ang alam ko, ang mahirap kasi sa vaccine niya, once it's tested, it has to be replicated. And the replication really takes time. Mahirapan tayo sa online class. That's true. Mahirap talaga ang online class, especially sa ating na nagba-blackout and so on and so forth. Baka bukas wala ng COVID. Yes, City, I hope the same. Sana bukas, inshallah, wala ng COVID. Baka hindi na bumalik sa normal ang lahat. Exactly, Mary Joy, no? Yun ang tinitingnan natin. Parang, siguro, feeling ko naman, hindi na babalik sa lahat. Hindi na babalik kung ano yung before, pero we will be better people. We just hope for that. Hindi na babalik yung dati, pero we're better people now. Okay? So, baka hindi makapagtapos dahil sa pandemic, dahil sa unstable jobs. That's true. Baka we won't be able to use our full potential. Totoo, no? Honestly, especially sa field ninyo, that you need hands-on, that you need skill-based orientation, mahirap yung online lang because you cannot just tell like your patient to do an online procedure, correct? Oo, baka mag-online procedure ka ng pag-replace ng heart and so on and so forth. Mahirap kasi yun, di ba? That's why feeling ko this has to be resolved as early as possible. Baka di na makope with the new normal, baka mag-struggle talaga sa online education. That's true. This online class is really a struggle for most of us. Lalo na sa mga students who live sa mga provinces, no, na unstable yung internet connection, na mahirap makapag-connect mismo. Even as simple as checking email is difficult, mahirap yun. Baka hindi na ako maka-enroll. So, hopefully, alin, no, maka-enroll ka pa rin because, you know, other people even thought of not attending this school year, no? Other people thought of stopping for a year because of the pandemic. Hopefully, that will not be a problem for most of us, no? Baka mas lalong maging mahalang blood plasma donor. I heard, no, they're selling it for roughly 10 to 30,000. Yeah. And that's illegal. Baka hanggang dito na lang lahat. Wag naman sana for, no? Wag naman sana hanggang dito yung lahat. Sana, baka naman hanggang dito lang tayo. Sana hanggang ngayon na lang, correct? Baka hindi maging effective ang pag-start ng class this August. I feel the nurse, no? Kasi kahit nga kami, in our institution, we're trying our best to come up with the platform, with an avenue wherein we really can, you know, come up with a possible resolution kung paano lahat ito gagawin. Baka mas madali pa lang hindi na magte-test na positive pala. Baka mas madami pa lang. Totoo, that's always my apprehension, no? Para bang, I understand the government, pero yung mga points na habang patagal ng patagal, mas dumadami. But they would say naman daw, pag marami ngayon, hopefully, mga weeks to come, months to come, mababa na. Kasi nga, I think in Zamboanga, we are, I'm not saying it's a mass testing, but it's semi-mass testing. Kasi marami na tayong tinetest of all the cities in the Philippines. Parang we're one of those leading in terms of testing people. Baka nag-circulate lang ang virus. Yeah, baka wala na silang pera pambili ng pagkain. That's also, may ano, no? Tayo nga, no? We are in an institution na hihirapan tayo sa food natin. Much more yung mga nawalan ng trabaho. Baka PH is going to be province of China. Sana hindi. Mm-hmm. Baka mabaon tayo sa utang sa National Bank. Feeling ko, princess, baon na talaga tayo sa utang. We'll just have to find like a way on how we can generate income. Later on, that's part of my talk. How do we generate income? Sige, thank you very much. So, huli na tayo. Dapat, ano yung mga commitment niyo as would-be nurses, as would-be doctors, as would-be, if meron dito sa inyo gusto maging medical technologies, radiologic technologies, and so on and so forth. Ano-ano yung mga resolutions or commitment na maibibigay mo or actions na feeling mo kaya mong gawin in your own level para masolusyonan yung ating mga sana at dapat. Sige, I'm giving you a minute or two to just key it in. Ano yung mga solution perhaps or commitments na pwede nating ibigay or mga actions kumbaga in order for us to some sort of para bang mabawasan man lang kung anong nafe-feel natin ngayon. Sige. A minute or two. Dapat we need to study harder for the betterment of our future. Char, I like that, Shelo. That's true. I like that. Totoo naman, no? At the end of the day, we are working hard because we want to serve the country. Ganun naman eh. We always end up to be doing or suffering perhaps now and doing everything for the country. Mag-aral, magbabasa na ako. I like that, Sarah, no? Yung kumbaga parang this is, the pandemic is making you realize what you missed out. Embody empathy. I like that, AC. Para bang instead of plainly just blaming the government, plainly just talking against the celebrity or so on and so forth in the issue of ABS-CBN and other stuff, anti-terror law and so on and so forth, we try to be empathic. We try to empathize enough before we rant. Hindi na maging tama. That's good, Joshua. Sana. Dapat efficient and competent ang gobyerno. I think, no, Ara, maraming competence sa gobyerno. It's just that I think naging problema na natin sa government is just it's the priority eh. Parang hindi nila nagiging priority kung anong nangyayari ngayon. That's why we have to really work harder in order to achieve that. Next, we have dapat gamitin natin ang pandemic na to as a lesson to fix the broken system we have. Totoo yun, Jillian, no? Sabi nga nila, inabasa kong quote, ang sabi, the pandemic daw kasi did not break the system. It exposed a wrong or a broken system in the first place. Dapat always positive but not to COVID. True par, no? Dapat maging positibo tayo pero wag naman sana sa COVID. Yeah. Dapat maging, wag na matigas ang ulo, that's good. Dapat ipaglaban natin ang rights natin. Yes, Vaughn. Dapat maging positibo. Stay at home lang, please. Wag muna maglaag. Dapat mas galingan natin sa pag-aaral. That's true. Stay at home. Dapat sumunod na lang sa gobyerno. Dapat lahat makamarcha at makatoga. That's true, Princess. Gusto ko yan. Dapat everybody will make it. Lahat tayo sabay-sabay nag-lockdown. Dapat sabay-sabay din tayo magmamarcha. Dapat maging strong physically and mentally. Take full advantage of the situation instead of thinking about other people, what others fail to do. Physical, yeah, dapat may physical class talaga sa RLE natin. This is related learning experience, right? Oo, dapat. Dapat maging positibo. Okay, dapat maging RN tayo. Magkaroon tayo ng way para makatulong sa ibang lubos na nangangailangan kahit sa simpleng palaan lamang. Share what we have. Yes, Ryan, that's what we're going to talk about this afternoon. How can we help other people? Most specifically, how can we help our families at home? And how can we help ourselves in order to really build a good foundation in our homes and communities? So what we're going to talk about this afternoon, again, we are going to strengthen the bonds in our homes, in our community, and in ourselves by this session on the screen between us. So we're done with SBD. So the first we're going to do is we communicate and reconnect. Yun ang lagi natin tinitignan. During a difficult time kasi, ang pinaka-importanteng konsiderasyon na kailangan natin ay malaman and matutunan is really to communicate. This is not just limited to government's effort, but so much from the family. Para bang ano-ano yung mga na-miss out nyo during the pandemic? Let's be very honest. Sometimes we don't want to stay at home. Sometimes we feel we're not ourselves when we are home. Sometimes we feel that our family is not para bang contented with the effort we give in school. We get a 90, they want a 95. We get a 95, they want a 100. Parang ganun. And sometimes, most of us prefer really with other people, not relatives from our family. You see, school is where you go home from. but it's really in your own house where you go home to. Kaya napaka-importante kung ano yung relationship natin sa bahay. So when I say communicate, this is where we start eating together. You have to ask yourself, kailan ba yung huling time before the pandemic na kumain kami ng sabay-sabay? In our case, being a Sinama and Tausug, sabay-sabay kasi kaming kumakain. Sa floor pa yan ha, kahit may mesa kami. So you see, hindi naging problema sa amin ang eating together kasi we always do that. But the only difference during the pandemic and before, mas marami kaming time ngayon kasi we no longer have to go out after. Kasi some people, after they eat, they leave the house. So I mean, hindi, hindi ka nakakaalis. So parang, when during the pandemic, you try to communicate. Find time asking each how they're doing. Discuss about your plans or talk about their aspirations. Pwede din naman, alam ko ginagawa ng iba to, no? Nung during the pandemic, kasi syempre idle ka, bored ka. So what you do to communicate, dito na siguro take advantage nursing students. Makipag-closure na kayo sa ex. If that's what you needed now. This is the time na kailangan nyo nang ayusin kung anong hindi naayos noon. Kailangan i-fulfill kung ano yung pagkukulang noon. But it doesn't mean you're going to go back together. The point there is, it's always a nice feeling when closure was given. Alam mo yung parang, okay lang makipag-communicate ulit kasi nga nagka-closure kayo. So try to reconnect. Look sa Facebook kung saan yung childhood friends ninyo, elementary classmates mo, reconnect with them. You know, this is the time wherein you add your cousins again as friends. And I know some of you don't add relatives as part of your sharing of memes. I know that. I feel you. Because some relatives do not understand the level of the meme-ness that we share. You see, that's fine. That's totally fine. So you start reconnecting. Okay? You communicate more. Ito yung time na kinakailangan siguro nating isipin kung ano ba yung rason bakit nagka-pandemic? Maybe the pandemic is teaching us something. And maybe the pandemic is teaching us to communicate more. Maybe technology has brought us very close to people far from us, but very far to people who are close to us. Baka nagiging ganun na kasi tayo. So rethink. Okay, so the first one that you're going to do in strengthening relationship is you communicate and learn to reconnect. Second, you organize your digital life. This is very, very important. Alam mo yun, one of the signs of being a mature student is checking email is becoming a part of your routine. Napapansin niyo yan recently, nag-check na kayo ng email. That means we're maturing. So you organize this time your digital life. So tignan mo, what are the photos you have in the past that you no longer want people to, you know, check on them? Remember, idle yung mga tao ngayon. This is the time that most of them check pictures on Facebook, stalk you on Facebook or Instagram. So tanggal mo na lang yung tanggalin, please. Okay. And of course, if unorganized, you take some time to clean the digital files. Look at your laptop, look at your cell phone, ano-ano yung mga photos na kailangan ng i-delete, apps na kailangan ng pakawalan, or even messages na kailangan ng burahin. Sometimes kasi, those memories are the ones that put us together, but also those are the ones we have to let go of. No, so you organize that. Tignan nyo kung meron kayong mga duplicate na photos naka-store saan-saan, tanggalin nyo na yon. Update your social media profiles. For example, kung before nagtatrabaho ka sa puso ni crush or nagtatrabaho ka sa Krusty Krab, palitan mo na. Oo, hindi na kasi yun. We have to maintain a professional profile this time. Kasi diba, years 2-3 years from now, you'll be what? Professional nurses? Registered nurses? So palitan niya. Okay, start collecting your credentials, collecting your achievements, and place them on your profile bio. It's always nice to have a professional smooth bio. Para bang hanggang ngayon, ang nakalagay pa rin sa bio mo, work sa puso ng crush or sa puso ni whoever. So start, no? You go through your emails, work on your personal, what do you call this, resume. You can also do that. So what you can do is, you organize your digital life in such a way that you're making yourself ready into a world where everything is online. It's a demand. You see, because sometimes you no longer talk to people to get opportunities or responsibilities. They look at your profile. They look at your social media posts. I can even remember when I first got into my professional, there was a time that I have to remove perhaps some tweets that I've been doing, some posts that I've been doing, some Facebook memes I've been sharing because they're no longer on a professional level. I'm not saying you come up with a dummy account. My point is we have to be very careful in what things we post online and what are the photos we share to other people because, you know, we have to organize our digital life. Third, virtual gathering. Ito nang in ngayon eh. Like what we're doing now, this is a virtual gathering. So, ang maganda kasi sa virtual gathering, which is, by the way, making everything else looks normal. Para bang, I know it appears that I'm just in front of you. So, ang maganda kasi sa virtual gatherings natin, like this one in Zoom, it's flexible and interactive. Alam mo yun, kahit may screen nga that separates us, it's still flexible because we still get to communicate. And perhaps that's the essence of why we have virtual gatherings to, again, go back to the first point, to communicate. And by the way, it is cost-efficient and user-friendly. Kasi nga, you won't spend, of course, for others, no. As sa aming kasi sir, we spend for the internet eh. Sa aming kasi sir, we spend for Wi-Fi and so on and so forth. User-friendly naman kasi siya because it's easy to navigate. I know you noticed that, no? To our future nurses, mapapansin ninyo, ay huo, no? Madali lang in-navigate yung Zoom. Hindi siya komplikado. It doesn't require much information. Although safety features will always be an issue, but at least in terms naman of what you put in sa Zoom ninyo na account, make sure it's safe. And again, it's an excellent lead generating tool. Alam mo yung in the new normal, this is what they have now. Although, aside from Zoom, we have other learning management systems naman na ginagamit. Pero yun nga lang, because Zoom is very accessible. Plus, the next point, it increases audience reach. Ang daming participants kayang pumasok at the same time. Ang iba naman kasing virtual gathering apps, limited lang yung features, limited lang din yung kanilang mga members or audience na pwedeng pumasok. But with this virtual gathering, you have to make sure, yun na nga, no, na-remind ng host natin kanina, na ito yung mga things. What's so good about this, Aneno, no? We are introduced to the new normal, but we're guided. So I would really like to thank, no, Ateneo de Zamboanga and Western Mindanao State University, and of course, to Universidad de Zamboanga, Brent and Pilar for really coming up with a program like this. You see, I think this is one of the biggest programs in Zamboanga. And we give credits to the committees for coming up with this type of webinar. Kasi it's really enriching. Eh. Nakakatuwa that young minds like yours are coming up with brilliant ideas. Kudos to our working committee. Next, we have invest in income generating projects. Alam ko, most of us know, yung baon lang talaga ang meron tayo. And some of us are struggling because na-lock up tayo sa Zamboanga. We cannot go to our provinces. Sometimes we cannot go out because a few of you perhaps or a lot of you are below 21. So, mahirap lumabas ng bahay. Hindi mo alam kung how you're going to survive for a day. So, what you can do is you invest on income-generating projects or initiatives. Ano-ano to? This is the time that money is an issue. Totoo yan. Even if you're not working, it's an issue, I know. So what you can do is you venture into online selling. This is a thing now, right? Alam ko meron sa inyo dito nag-venture na sa online selling. Pwedeng foods, pwede namang goods. Recently, no, Zamboanga launched its bartering community. Nakakatuwa sa bartering community kasi when you start decluttering, alam mo yung maghahalungkat ka sa garage, maghahalungkat ka sa bodega, maghahalungkat ka sa kwarto mo, and may mga things doon na feeling mo hindi mo nagagamitin and other people might use it or might need them. So you exchange it for goods that you also needed. So ang maganda kasi sa barter, there's no exchanging of money, only exchanging of goods. So you venture on that. Ngayon, pagkatapos ng webinar na to, baka feel nyo mag-declutter, so you go, you know, if we let go of sentimental things, that means we want other people to feel what we felt when we first took hold of that material. So make them feel that way. Para bang, I know it's difficult to let go of the materials you've been keeping for a number of years. But you see, for you, it's just for sentimental value. But other people might feel it's a need. Other people might feel it's for them to survive. So, magandang exchange yun sa barter. Another is meron tayong mga online sellers na nagbebenta ng ulam, ng food. I see them, no? I have tried buying food from a local chef and so on and so forth. Maganda siya because we are also patronizing our own. We are also helping other people, kumbaga, earn ba for a living. Ikaw, for example, if there are things na you think you can do, so you can start coming up perhaps with your own Facebook page. That's where you start selling. You invest. Kasi I know investment naman is not 100% yes. It's not all the time you get what you invested. But the point there is, at least you took risk. At least you were able to finally realize that you can go somewhere else, that you can do something else than just plainly sitting sa room or sa house nyo, waiting for the sun to set and the sun to rise. See, there are a lot of things we can do. But please, before you can go to income generating projects or initiatives, please, you have to know the market. Dapat alam nyo how it works, ha? It doesn't mean na may pera ka, you know, the business. You build connections. You know, you can use your Facebook, you can use your MyDay, you can use your Twitter. You see, build connections within the social media you have. That's where you sell things to other people and get a feedback from them and post the feedback with their permission. And then that's the time that, you know, sometimes a particular thing grows because people like, you know, because people like it and people share. So when they share, that means they like your product. So other people might want to try. And when they like it and the cycle continues, ganun lang naman eh. We have a lot of successful stories for local businesses. So you might want to grab that. And of course, you have to learn the process. It's not easy. It takes a lot of reading. It takes a lot of experiments. It takes a lot of pain and suffering and frustrations. It's like that. It doesn't automatically give you a flower. You know, you always begin with the soil. So you have to make sure you know how to grab the soil in order for your plant perhaps to bloom. It's not easy. It takes time. But you know, it's worth it. Okay, so you invest on income generating projects. Next, draw on your skills. Ito na yung time na, alam mo yung, it's a transition period. Parang most of us, hindi ko kasi alam, sir, kung ano yung kaya kong gawin. So what you can do is, ganito muna, you have to make sure your routines are, maybe may nabago sa routine mo, but you have to make sure hindi ganun kagrabe yung changes sa routine mo. So what you can do is, saan ka ba magaling? Isipin mo muna, saan ba ako magaling? Anong skill ba, na saan ako magaling? At anong skills na gustong gusto ko matutunan before, pero I haven't tried it because I was busy with school. For example, marunong ka mag-draw. Then you commission, perhaps you give them a sample portfolio or perhaps a group of photos, and then if other people would like to have the same, commission them. And also pag ikaw naman din ang magkukuha ng services ng other people, do not just get it for free, 'di ba? I mean, it's a skill eh. You don't just say, ay, drawing lang naman yan. No, it's not. It takes a lot of skill. You buy the materials, you just don't get it from a national bookstore. So, you commission. Start video editing. If may mga incoming events like this one, pwede kang mag-volunteer to start to video edit. And then eventually, if they like your video edit, you will be recommended. Recommendation is a really good practice in this particular platform. Alam mo yung ni-recommend ka lang na magaling ka, tapos nang tuloy-tuloy na siya. So you start in that. Magaling naman ako, sir, sa video. Marunong ako sa video editing, sir, pero hindi ako magaling. So that's the time you try, you know, being better. You check on how other people do. You don't copy what other people do. You just have to get an inspiration from them. Next, tignan, magaling ka ba magsulat ng narratives and poetry? Then you start, you know, coming up with a page that's about poetry. Once you get a number of shares and so on and so forth, that's also money, di ba? It gets monetized. So if you're this type of person who writes poetry and narratives, like I did once, like an article of mine and a poem got featured in an American Facebook page, although it wasn't monetized. But you see, there's a fulfillment that you get from that. Or start doing Wattpad. You know, you can start writing on Wattpad and, you know, who knows, years from now, you'll be the next She's Dating the Gangster phenomenal film, di ba? Turn into film from a Wattpad story. May mga ganun eh. You know, this is the time that we have to look at our strength. And of course, we capitalize on our strengths and we have to improve on our weaknesses. Next, you sing and develop your range. kung feeling mo yung ito lang yung range mo sa singing, you try to do more, you know. There are other apps that you can, you know, you do covers, for example, on YouTube. So when you do covers on YouTube, if it gets a certain number of subscriptions and gets a number of hits, then therefore it gets monetized. And of course, you dance. You know, if you're good at dancing, and consider other genre. Baka hip-hop lang yung gusto mo and you realize you're good at other genre. So, and if you dance, for example, TikTok, I know TikTok is thinking of monetizing whatsoever number of likes or shares or whatsoever. I'm not really familiar with how things are on TikTok, but you see, they're also thinking of monetizing that. So you see, you think of skills na meron ka. I know, ang worry mo, wala kasi akong skill, sir. Lahat tayo may skill. Maybe hindi mo pa na-master or you're just afraid of doing it because maybe people will judge you. People will always judge, believe me, no matter what you do. So do what you love. Because anyways, whatever you do, they will. Okay? So start. You have to draw on your skills. Tignan kung saan ka magaling. Tignan kung saan pwedeng, you know, gumanda ang ating pakiramdam. You know, in this trying time, all we need perhaps is just a positive mindset. So laging tandaan yan. Next, you start playing game and reading books. I know, in the Philippines naman, I don't know, isipin, no, when was the last time you played Uno? Siguro kami, sa school, sometimes we do, no? But even the indoor basketball, when was the last time you did that? So, you consider pandemic as this. Consider pandemic as your cage childhood. Remember your childhood, pero cage. Kumbaga, remember how much you love going out on 12 noon and you pretended to sleep because your mother doesn't want you to go out. Remember that. Recall a moment that you wore a white shirt and went with the dirty white shirt. Remember the times when you just go home to drink water and go out again in the scorching heat just to play? We miss that feeling and I want that feeling to be back. Okay? You start playing games. I know this time it's not safe to go out, but all the things you've been doing in the childhood, make it cage it. Make it indoor. Maybe this is the time na I know most siblings are not in good terms, no? It's always a problem with siblings, yung mga 1 or 2 years lang yung gap. But you see, perhaps this is the time that you reach out to your younger or older siblings. You start playing, you start getting to know each other. Alam ko, we only talk to our siblings when we need something. Like, nasan yung tuwalya? May ulam pa ba? Nasaan si mama? Kailan siya uuwi? Nasaan yung toothpaste? These are the only conversations we have with our siblings. But you see, maybe this time, you play games with them. Teach them how to play. Teach them how to play Uno. You know, teach them how to play Monopoly. Board games. Indoor games. Teach them. Or maybe if they're better, ask for help. Sometimes kasi our siblings are just waiting for us to reach out. If you are the more mature person, be it you're younger or older, you have to reach out. This is the time that we needed to know our siblings more. And of course, read books. There's no other way we learn but we read. Okay? Make sure you download. Sa nursing pa naman, maraming kailangang isipin, alalahanin, concepts, na, especially to those na magme-medicine, ang dami mong kailangan basahin. Why not start today? Why not start reading a book? Why not start downloading all the PDF files available on the internet? I know, nakakapagod siya. I know, minsan lazy tayo magbasa. You see, this is the course you have chosen, so you have to live by its rules. That means you have to read more and more and more. Science is not like other profession that you can say sorry if someone died. It's not the case. It's not being a teacher that you can just erase the writings on the board when you committed a mistake. You are holding people's lives. And one wrong mistake can kill them. And there's no going back. So you have to make sure you have to study very, very well. This is true to all medical courses in the country and even outside the country. No, you have to make sure we're ready. We have to prove to perhaps our patients that we are competent and credible as nurses and medical practitioners, okay? Next, we have to analyze our budget. This is very, very, very important. Stop online shopping. Especially if you know that you can no longer survive the week or month. Most of us kasi, I know, no, para bang, ay, may maganda sa Zalora, ay, may maganda sa, ay, magpa-Food Panda tayo. You see, I mean, I don't really naman, don't get it against me, no? Don't take it against me. Okay lang tayo magpa-Food Panda. Okay lang naman tayo magpa-deliver ng food. But you see, yeah, we're helping them earn a living, but you also have to make sure you're practical. If this is the analyze your budget. If this is the amount I can spend for an online delivery for one meal versus if I am buying it on Talipapa or our, you know, local market. So you have to weigh things out. Remember, we are not certain on how or when this will end, but we are certain that our money will run out of, you know, where we're going to run out of cash. So you have to make sure you analyze. Isipin muna kung kailangan mo ba talagang umorder ng wireless AirPods. Isipin mo muna kung kailangan mo ba talaga ng bagong shoes. Isipin mo muna before ka mag-mine. Okay? Isipin mo muna, maganda yung sweater, maganda yung hoodie, but always have to make sure, is this what you needed for the moment? If you think you have enough, then you have to save. Remember, emergencies are not announced. You know, no one will tell you, okay, next week pala, magkakasakit ka ha, so you have to make sure you save. It's not the case. They're called emergencies for a reason. So you have to make sure you save. You start saving. Oo, nakikita natin, kasi sir, yun kasi yung pantanggal ko ng stress, yung magmamine ako, yung mag-order ako sa Food Panda. Alam mo yung sir, may experience ko man lang, makareceive ng message, your food is being delivered to your doorstep. Or mabigyan man lang ako, sir, ng bouquet sa El Regalo and other services na meron sa Zamboanga. Yeah, I know. We all wanted that. Diba? Sometimes, pag nakikita mo sa Facebook, nakaka-receive sila ng bouquet na papasana all ka na lang. I feel you. But the point there is, what's more important? Okay? You have to think of ano yung mga... Kumbaga, pag nasa bahay tayo, if you're living with your family, pag hindi naman ikaw yung panganay, it's not so much as of a struggle. But if you are the eldest in the family and your family is somehow dependent on you, you make a list. Ano-ano ba yung kailangan nating bayaran sa week na to? Sa month na to? Remember, there was a time na nagkaroon ng freeze of payment ng bills, but they're back. So, kailangan ba i-list doon muna how much are we spending for the electric bill? How much are we spending for the water bill? How much are we spending for our internet bill? How much are we spending for a week? How much are we spending for other things we need? We need. Again, we need, not we want. Okay, think of that. There's still other time and other, you know, different, siguro time na lang ba kung kailan pwede tayong bumili or perhaps tignan yung mga gusto natin. Okay? But I know, if you're going to look at it closely naman, kasi ang mura ng lahat ngayon, I feel you, no? Marang, ang dami kasi sir mura ngayon. Alam mo yung bibili ka ng sweater na Uniqlo 100 lang, na Puma 100 lang, na iba't ibang brand 150 lang. I know. But that 150 may be, you know, an amount for you na kaya lang, but for other people it's not eh. So you have to make sure we think of it that way. Next, you nurture your mental health. This is very, very important. Let's be very honest. We are stressing out. In what? March, April, May, June, July? Almost 5 months. I know there was a time in the 5 months that you felt you are no longer parang yourself. There was a time that you are running out of things to do. There are times you want to do not so good things. There were perhaps times you had suicidal thoughts. There were times you felt depressed. There were times you felt unwanted. There were times you felt you just would want to die. And that part of being stressed and depressed is, I know, what COVID is trying to teach us from. There are other things we can do. You have to learn how to nurture your mental health. You talk to people. You talk to your families at home. You see, we have been struggling, but one thing is for sure, this struggle will end. So, what are the characteristics of people who are mentally healthy have? First, sense of contentment. I know this is the time that you compare yourself to other people. Bakit sila naso-survive nila yung pandemic? Bakit sila okay ang wifi connection nila? Bakit kami hindi? But if you're going to weigh down, you have more blessings than other people. it's just that other people don't really announce their hardships. That's why they look okay. Yun lang eh. Always remember that we all have hardships. Second, a zest for living and the ability to laugh and have fun. Don't forget, of course, to, you know, from time to time, talk to your friends na nasa ibang lugar, provinces, for example, na feeling mo, like, hindi mo na sila nakakausap kung okay lang ba sila. Pag wala namang internet, you can call them, you can message them, no? May mga ways naman din. And ikaw din, you have some fun. Ano ba? Sa akin kasi, sir, nakakatulong yung when I play ML with my friends para maging okay lang yung state of being ko, then do it. But don't reach to the don't reach to a point naman that you're no longer sleeping, that you're getting addicted to it, that there are responsibilities you can no longer to do, or you skip eating or meals. It's not that. It's always nice to have, for example, to have something to do when you are experiencing, you know, some sort of stress or depression, but you have also to make sure that it doesn't result to another problem. Okay? Next, the ability to deal with stress and bounce back from the adversity. I know most of us, ako din naman eh, ano lang kayo, mga moment persons lang tayo. Ibig sabihin, ngayon lang pagod ka, pero mamaya okay ka na. Bukas pagod ka na naman ulit. Ngayon okay ka na naman. That's why sabi nga nila, never make decisions in the extreme of your emotions. Ibig sabihin, when something bad happens to you, you have to assess first the situation before you say something. When you're too happy, for example, too overwhelmed with what's happening to you, mag-isip muna before mag-post, before perhaps you confront someone and so on and so forth. Because it's very important, eh? It's very important that we think critically before we make actions. And of course, if you are mentally healthy, you can balance both work and place and the rest of the activities. Parang alam ko no minsan, nasasabi mo to sa sarili mo, you have survived the day. Parang last year no, most of you naman siguro hindi no first year sa nursing. So parang feeling mo nga hindi mo alam ba't mo na-survive yung last year. But you see, you're here. Meaning to say, you survived last year. So ibig sabihin na babalance mo yun. Although, may mga responsibilities ka naman ng iwan. But what's important naman is, you have to, kumbaga, learn ba how to perhaps say no, how to perhaps say, I cannot do it. Kasi sometimes kasi, para bang if we cannot balance doing things, mahirap siya eh. Baka you might end up doing everything all at once. So, and it causes you to be stressed out with things. So, nababawasan yung ating, what do you call this, time para sa ibang bagay. And of course, the ability to build and maintain fulfilling relationships. Importante yun. When you think your friendship is falling apart, go back and think of the reason why you started it in the first place. If you think your relationship with your partner, girlfriend, boyfriend is falling apart, think of the reasons why you have gone this far. If you think your relationship with your family is falling apart, think of the reason why you're still at home. This will really make you feel na, ay oo, no, siguro naman kasi it's not all the time na sila ang may pagkukulang. Sometimes kasi we always feel na sila yung may pagkukulang, kaya tayo yung nagiging victim. You also have to think about, maybe ikaw, meron ka rin pagkukulang. Maybe you weren't able to reach out. Maybe you weren't able to talk to them fully. Maybe you were just too, perhaps, preoccupied with things. Minsan kasi ganun eh. Minsan, napapabayaan natin yung ibang bagay kasi we give like something more time than the others. I know it's still going to be balancing, no? It's still going to be, at the end of the day, will fall on time management. So learn how to manage your time. Okay, so I'm also looking at it. I'm also trying to manage the time. Okay, next. This is important. Deep clean your home. Okay? I don't know when was the last time you took hold of perhaps a broom ba kung meron or a mop. I don't know when was the last time you did that, but it's very important if you try to clean the house, no? I-move yung mga gamit, you know, i-try nyong baguhin yung interior ninyo. Pag katulad namin, wala namang babaguhin sa interior, magwalis-walis na lang, you know. Cut the trees kung meron kayo sa labas, lawn, or, you know, siguro mag-isip, kailangan natin siguro i-move tong furniture na to, or mas maganda sana pag dito yung TV. You know, you do that. You know, it, sometimes it's not really about feng shui or moving furniture. It's about having a different outlook. Para bang pagtitingnan mo, parang normal na kasi na dito ka nakatingin kasi nandito yung TV. So what if naman i-change mo yung angle ng TV for a change of perception? Perspective rather. Alam mo yung may ganun tayo. Para bang we are trying to move the furniture at home, not because, you know, it doesn't look great, but because we need also to shift our attention. So pwedeng ganun. No, mag-start ka, deep clean your house, start cooking perhaps. You know, ako naman, I don't really cook well, no, but because of YouTube and other Facebook videos na napapanood ko, we are, you know, inspired to cook. Para bang you give a twist on a certain Filipino meal and then you realize, oh, it's good pala. So you start being, you know, ganun lang. You try to look at your home, ano-ano nga yung mga bagay na pwede mong gawin doon. And again, mag-add ka din ng mga list. For example, if you have enough lang naman, no, for those dito sa inyo na meron namang enough resources, you can put a list on what are the things you need at home pa. And then this is the time siguro na magkarpintero tayo. This is the time na palitan yung bubong. This is the time na linisin yung mga sulok-sulok. This is the time na magtanim tayo, no? Minsan yung iba sa atin, ito mga plantita or plantito. Okay, so yung mga succulent-succulent natin, yung mga cacti natin dyan, pa-arrange-arrange tayo. You see, sometimes kasi it's giving us a fresh perspective. Alam mo yung, when you see people on Facebook do it, you're inspired to do the same in your house kasi they look really good aesthetically and of course, they're really helping the environment. So mag-isip, ano-ano ba yung gusto namin i-add sa bahay namin? Ay, gusto ko sa side na to, meron kami isang plant. Or for example, if you think na meron kayong mga plants din doon na hindi nyo na naitatapon nyo lang, isubukan mong i-barter, baka sa ibang tao kailangan yung mga plans na yun. Ganun yung gagawin nyo, no? Try your best to look at the sulok-sulok. And one thing I like about, you know, cleaning homes, you always find valuable things. Ang maganda yung bubuksan mo yung old wallet mo or old bag mo, makikita mo yung mga letters doon. Pwedeng letter from your former teacher, pwedeng letter from a friend, pwedeng letter from an ex, no? You realize mo, hala, oo nga, no, mahal na mahal niya pala talaga ako noon. Tapos iniwan niya lang pala ako ngayon. You see, but you realize that's the type of love you had before. Marirealize mo, hala, oo, no, iniwan lang ako nito pagkatapos ng 3 buwan. You know, things like that. But you realize it's a good thing. It's a good thing kasi marami kang mahanap. For example, may mga tinapon kang teddy bear, ganyan, syempre magbe-break na kayo. O, pag magbe-break tayo, dalhin mo na lahat ng mga binigay mo, nandiyan na sa isang box. Siyempre, ayaw tanggapin. So, itatago mo yun doon. Tapos, ma-realize mo, ito pa rin dapat ibibigay ko sa kanya. Ah, iba-barter ko na lang. Oh, you see? You barter what your boyfriend or girlfriend gave you to get something you really wanted. For example, you can trade the teddy bear into what? Yakult? What? A box of Chucky? Or what? Like 12-inch pizza? Or a pan of spaghetti? You see? Or you wanted perhaps some siguro goods from the grocery. Marami, diba? So, think of the ways. You start this afternoon, tignan yung mga ano. Basta ako, I always love cleaning the home because I always find something precious, pleasurable. Tapos, makikita ko kung gaano tayo ka-jologs before. I know, photos, photo albums, negatives, old pictures, old stuff, old shoes, old clothes. You see? They make us realize na this is the life I had before. And sometimes, no, whether, you know, believe it or not, sometimes you always want to go back to how things were. Because things in the past were simple, we were happy, we weren't thinking much. But you see, maybe that part of our life, it's something we cherish, but it's not something we have to forever stay at. Because we have to improve. And improving means suffering. Before someone gets to improve, someone needs to suffer. If you're always happy, then you're not improving because you are not holistically formed yet. You know? So yun ang maganda naman sa deep cleaning your home. Imagine nyo, from deep cleaning your home, napunta tayo sa ating mga nararamdaman sa puso. Okay, next. Enjoy sunshine and exercise if you can. I know, self-isolation and social distancing, pinapatupad yan. But it doesn't mean naman siguro na you also limit yourself from going out. Okay lang naman siguro lumabas tayo sandali sa bahay para, you know, magpahangin, magpainit man lang siguro. Kasi if you also always stay inside your home and do nothing, parang you always feel like you're tired of everyday. Nakakapagod ang maraming ginagawa, pero mas nakakapagod ang walang ginagawa. You just wait for everything to dry up, wait to eat, to go online, nakakapagod siya. So what you can do is you enjoy the sunshine, but of course, protocol, social distancing, wearing of masks, disinfecting, you know, they are very important. And of course, exercise if you can. Natutuwa nga ako no recently, I see a lot of former students, former colleagues, friends on Facebook who are really working out. Nakakatuwa because they're, sabi ko nga sa sarili ko, ba't hindi ko yun magawa? Why are other people, para bang kaya nilang mag-allot ng time of the day where they work out, where they do things, and I can't. Just realize it's not easy pala. I would always have a dilemma. I know a few of you here perhaps can also relate, no? I was not so big before, but when I started, you know, when I started growing, nung nag-start akong tumaba, nabawasan yung self-esteem ko, and nabawasan yung times na para bang gagawin ko na ayoko na. There was a time I enrolled at the gym, I paid for the fee for a certain month, and then when I saw people, bakit walang mataba sa gym? So, kinabukasan din ako pumunta, but sayang because I paid for the registration and so on and so forth. But you see, sometimes pala, no, it's a matter of perspective. Then I realize, maybe my way of exercising may not be like what other people do. Maybe my way of being healthy will not be going to the gym and be toned and buff and so on and so forth. Maybe my way of exercising is through reading, although I know it doesn't really help in your, you know, size and whatsoever. But I think it's always a matter of just choose what's going to make you happy. Again, physical fitness is very important. Especially kayo, no, sa mga medical profession. Alam nyo yung importance ng health. Alam nyo yung importance ng gaano ka, kumbaga, importante, by the way, kung meron kang inaalat na time to work out and ito lang yung dapat ang kakainin mo. For a certain time, dapat hindi ka nakakain. I know that's very important. Pero may mga times din naman kasi, especially during the pandemic, no, that we break rules. But you see, you know, at the end of the day, it will always be fall down to what's making you happy. Okay? Kung feeling mo okay na yung walking na lang, sure. Kung feeling mo okay yung sa bahay ka lang mag-workout, sure. Ngayon pa naman, we're under GCQ. So, close ulit ang ating mga leisure and recreation. So, bawal ang gym, bawal ang may mga ilang percent lang sa salon and so on and so forth. So, mahirap siya eh. So, ito siguro yung time na mag-build tayo ng self natin at home. Okay, so, congratulations to those who lose weight and who got toned. To those who haven't started anything physical, that's fine. It's not a race. Okay? But you always have to make sure you look after your physical health. Next is maintain perspective. Alam ko, mahirap sa time na to ang maging positive sa buhay. Much more maging positive sa COVID. But it's always a struggle for people to maintain certain perspective. Isipin, ano ba yung mga bagay na gustong-gusto kong gawin? And think of that. Ako, whenever I feel sad, whenever I feel a little stressed out or depressed, I always think of ano ba yung gusto kong gawin or gustong-gusto kong gawin para hindi ako ma-stress. So, I always end up, you know, watching dogs on YouTube, watching babies on YouTube, or I end up watching mukbang, or I end up watching people challenges on TikTok, or I always end up plainly watching series. And sometimes, even if I cry for a series, but I'm fine after that. And there will always be series that's going to make you cry. There was never a Grey's Anatomy episode that I didn't cry. Seriously, there was never an episode in Orange is the New Black that I never cried. And for me, it's a good type of crying. It's a stress relieving type of crying. So think of a perspective kung saan yung feeling mo mailalabas mo lang yung, you know, sama ng loob. And always be reminded na ngayon, what you do, for example, other people, how do they maintain perspective? Sa Zamboanga, dumadami na yung cases. Honestly, when when we had 1, 2, 3 cases in Zamboanga, I was really on the news. I was really updated. Nung dumami na, habang dumadami pa, I got parang worried. So sabi ko pa, I will stop watching news. Kasi parang mas nag-worry ako. I stopped following the local government pages and some radio station Facebook pages kasi mas nasa-stress ako knowing na may mga additional cases naman. But you see, wala ka man magagawa because they all, other people, other friends share it, so you still get to see it. The point is, we maintain perspective, but let's also not forget that news is very important. Para bang, oo, minsan iniisip mo na lang na matatapos din naman to, di ba? Sabi nga nila, this too will pass. No? I mean, all everything naman will pass. I hope lang din talaga na when we try to maintain perspective, let's just always hope for the best. Okay? Next is instill concerns for all essential workers. Years from now, you'll be these people. Years from now, you'll be essential workers. There was even an article I read na kung hindi pa nagka-pandemic, hindi pa natin marirealize yung importance ng healthcare service. Kung hindi pa nag-pandemic, hindi pa natin bibigyan ng importance yung nurses, radio technologists, medical technologists, pharmacists, janitors, security guards, waitresses, and so on and so forth, waiters, and other essential workers, even teachers. Kung hindi pa nagka-pandemic, hindi pa natin maiisip kung gaano sila ka-importante. So, ngayon, para bang, siguro, let's be very honest, kahit siguro kayo may mga hesitations kayo. Halimbawa, pag nasa isang area kayo and you see someone wearing perhaps like a hospital uniform, sometimes you distance yourself. Para bang, uy, naka-uniform. So para bang galing hospital. May mga ganun tayong, although we don't really share or broadcast it, but we always have that mindset na parang, uy, galing tong hospital, galing to dito, so on and so forth. Or sometimes if we're commuting, mga nasa jeep tayo, so on and so forth, sometimes we become very paranoid because we're seated next to someone who's a health worker. You see, these are stigma that we really have to, you know, para bang subukan natin tanggalin sa ating mga mindset that we have to instill, you know, concerns for all the essential workers. Halimbawa, pumunta ka ng KCC, tapos mali or mahaba yung pila or parang naiinis ka sa security guard, you always extend your patience. Try your best to do that. Sa cashier, for example, pag pumipila ka sa magbabayad ng bills, you see, I know may mga times talaga na we become disrespectful to essential workers. Let's try to empathize, as what one of our participants made mention earlier, let's try to empathize. What if we become them? What if we are in their shoes? And someone is, you know, making us feel that. So, ngayon, when we try to instill concern, subukan din kasi nating ilagay yung sarili natin sa kanila. And by that, perhaps, we will realize na of all the times, importante kayo ngayon. That's why to all our participants watching and listening right now, you have to make sure you finish your studies. You have to make sure you become registered nurses because we need you. This is not the last pandemic, hopefully the last, but this is not the last healthcare dilemma or crisis that our country will face. So we need people like you. So always remember that we need like a workforce that's going to help our medical teams. Some Asian countries have lower cases of COVID because they have a strengthened, what they call this, medical service and government support. We also have to do the same in our country. No, there might be some lapses the government is doing as what, you know, we perhaps can see or feel. But you see, it's not the time to run. It's not the time to run after them. It's our responsibility to help. Because again, years from now, you will be them. You'll be the one, you know, working in the government services, the city health office, hospitals, both private and public. You know, we will be working at the end of in like 2 to 3 years. So let's always empathize and instill concerns to them. And of course, the last one is we combat misinformation online. Alam ko, this was already presented to you, no, first or second session nyo ata about combating misinformation. Tayo yung mas educated. Tayo yung mas nakakaalam. Before we share something, let's validate. Okay? Before we share information, let's validate. I remember there was this one time, my batchmate, di ba nauso yung meme na may sinasabi sila Tapos, yung picture o yung name, character sa isang series. For example, Meredith Grey from The Grey's Anatomy. So, my friend, kasi it was about the government daw, and so on and so forth. We thank the government for blah, 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 blah. Tapos Meredith Grey. It was the kasagsagan of our struggle sa pandemic until now naman we're struggling. But it was really the, kumbaga parang the height of the pandemic. So, my friend shared that. Sabi pa niya, you see, even American doctors daw are congratulating our government for doing a good job in ano, and then people are saying, friend, sa Grey's Anatomy man yan, hindi man yan totoo. Sabi niya pa, but she defended ha, herself, saying na, kahit na ang point naman dun, sinabi niya, you see, of all the time, we have to be, you know, literate. We have to, you know, this time kasi journalism is in a state of flux. Dito tayo, yung parang sa sobrang dami ng platforms, sa sobrang dami ng nagkiklaim ng news, mahirap nang i-segregate kung saan yung fake sa totoo. So, as would-be health workers, as would-be essential workers, medical practitioners, future of the country, you have to make sure before you share something, your sources are credible. Before you think of posting something online, naisip nyo muna kung credible ba yung source, or the least, think if it will benefit your followers, think if it will benefit your Facebook friends, or think if you will benefit from it before sharing something. Okay, so basically, those are the things we can look at when we talk about strengthening the relationship at home. So, to summarize it, let's look at it this way. We are known in the nursing community, we are known in the medical community to use mnemonic devices, correct? Para bang sa sobrang dami mong kailangan intindihin, dapat meron kang mnemonic device sa utak para matandaan mo yung concepts. And what I did with my presentation, I made a mnemonic device. So, in order for us to strengthen our relationship at home, we have to first communicate and reconnect. Meaning, we have to make sure we strengthen connection at home. Parang patalastas yun ng isang ano, internet provider. But besides the point. Okay, we first strengthen by connecting. Second, we organize our digital life. Let's look professional. Let's remove irrelevant information on our social media accounts. Next, we have to learn virtual gathering practices. Yung bang alam mo more than ever na ngayon yung time na kailangan lahat ng gatherings halos kasi bawal na face-to-face, virtual na. So dapat ikaw mismo, what's the best way for you to participate in virtual gatherings? Next, invest in income-generating initiatives. Mag-isip, go for bartering, go for online selling. If you have a skill, go, you know, of cooking, mag-start ka ng business mo. Connect with people. Mag-isip ng mga tao na kaya kang tulungan in terms of perhaps capital. Kung if your friend thinks na meron kang potential, then go. Next is draw on your skills. Saan ka ba talaga magaling and capitalize on them. Think kung saan saang parte ka magaling tapos dun mo subukan yung mga bagay. Kasi baka naman kasi in the first place, hindi mo lang binigyan ng chance ang sarili mo. Play games and read books. So maganda din yung lumabas tayo or kahit indoor games man lang. This is also to strengthen our relationship and to strengthen the ability of the brain to understand, read books, analyze your budget. Huwag pa-mine ng mine. Huwag pa-add to cart. Okay, always. Diba? You know, it's not always the case na, ay, okay, pa-add to cart tayo. It's not, no, hindi siya advisable na add to cart ka lang, especially that you are using your parents' money, not your own. Next, you nurture your mental health. Think of activities that will help your brain stimulize and think of activities that's not going to stress you out. If there's a need to talk to someone, a teacher, a guidance counselor, reach out. You know, if you notice, there have been a lot of suicidal tensions and incidents in the city. I know you have heard of that. Nung nasa peak tayo ng COVID, marami tayong mga cases wherein people committed suicide. And this is perhaps because of mental health. So this is the time because they have no one to talk to. They're all alone. They're struggling. They're in poverty. There's perhaps not to, you know, famine naman is like a deep word, no? But we are experiencing hunger. So ito yung time na let's some sort of like reach out. If you think that a friend is posting something on Twitter or on Facebook about, you know, some suicidal thoughts, reach out, chat them. You know, if they think, ay, wala yun, joke ko lang yun, then start a conversation. Perhaps they just needed someone to talk to. Or some people, you know, baka you might think, ay, pauta lang si attention. So it's not that, eh. If you chatted them and then it ends up as that, fine. But the point there is, you extended help. Next, deep clean your home. Tignan ang sulok-sulok. Baka may pwede pang gamitin. Check on other places. Move your furniture for a fresh perspective. Enjoy sunshine and exercise if you can. As much as possible. Lumabas tayo, no? Oo, mag-unat-unat tayo. I know most of us naman parang nakikita ko rin nag-gym and so on. That's good. Especially sa mga sa bahay lang. Hindi naman kasi safe plus they're still closed. So enjoy. You go out. Walk your dog or if you have a pet, you know, or you go somewhere nearest lang sa ano yun and try to walk late afternoon ba or early morning. That will really help. No? That will also help our mental health concerns. Next, maintain perspective. I know everything else around us is negative and try to maintain a positive perspective because that will really help you come up with fresh ideas. Next, instill concerns for all essential workers. Again, sabi ko nga, years from now, you will become the essential workers. So you have to make sure if you want people to instill concerns towards you, then starting today, instill the same. Okay? As simple as ako, for example, I no longer call the janitress, the security guard as kuya, uncle, or, you know, manong. I call them sir or ma'am. You know, and they would always say, ay, wag na sir, ano lang po, kuya lang or ate lang. No, kasi masyado naman daw formal. But my point is, it's not being formal. It's giving them the kind of respect they deserve. So that little thing will help them. Kaya nasanay ako of calling anyone sir or ma'am because kahit regardless of their status, regardless of their work, you have to maintain the sense of respect. You start by doing that. I think it helps. Especially sa mga drivers, no, sa mga jeepney drivers, they don't like it when you call them sir. You realize parang, wag naman sir, ano lang naman ako sir eh. They would always say, ano lang naman ako sir, jeepney driver. It's not that eh. It's not the point if you're a jeepney driver or what. The point there is it's respecting them. And of course, the last one is you combat misinformation on the internet or online. So as much as possible, dapat alam natin kung ano ba yung fake news over the other. We have to also make sure that we are certain of the things we share, especially memes or whatsoever on Facebook. Okay? So basically, that's COVID pandemic. Okay? So communicate, organize, virtual gathering, invest, draw on your skills, play games, analyze, nurture your mental health, deep clean your home, maintain perspective, instill concerns, and combat misinformation online. Okay, so those are the things na kailangan nating i-consider when we are doing or strengthening our relationships at home. So there you have it. That's for my session this afternoon on strengthening relationships at home. And of course, our references are very important. These are the references where I took my points from and just finally come up with COVID pandemic as a mnemonic device. Okay, salamat!